I would like to introduce our National Society, Turkish Red Crescent, you as a brief, the first. Then we want to share with you our approach for the World Humanitarian Summit. So first, I want to start by my presentation. You know, after the first Geneva Convention, 1864, the first Red Cross, ICRC, International Committee for Red Cross, established in Geneva. So after that, the Ottoman Empire signed that agreement and joined this movement in 1868. We are the first national society which using the emblem, the crescent emblem, the hilal. So we have our legal frame, international and domestic legal status we have, and mainly our responsibilities and the roles described in the IHL, International Humanitarian Law, and we have our own legislation in Turkey. Turkish Red Crescent has 700 branches in Turkey and 5,500 employees working in the Turkish Red Crescent Association, roughly 1 billion Turkish lira budget, annual budget we are spending and earning. What's our roles and responsibilities? You know, according to the sphere and the international humanitarian structure, we have our domestic responsibilities according to the internal regulation. We are the main solution partner in nutrition in Turkey for risk reduction plan. You know, AFAD, AFAD also the disaster management institution directly under Prime Minister office. So we are the boss in nutrition cluster, AFAD the boss in shelter cluster. So we are assisting AFAD. We are keeping continuously roughly 400,000. Also, 400,000 people nutrition and the shelter capacity in our warehouses and our branches. So sheltering and NFI, non-food items, water and sanitation, protection, psychosocial services to the needy people during the disaster or after the disaster in the early recovery phase or the, after that phase. So another our big responsibility, blood in Turkey. Roughly 3,000 employees working in our blood system. And we have duties for provision of medicine and the medical supplies during the emergency and the disasters, exchange of prisoners, hostilities of the war, delivery of families, messages, RFL restoring family links, you know, our common responsibilities as other International Red Cross and Red Crescent movement members. And cooperate with international movements like IFRC, ICRC, ICIC, and in other national societies. Our mission and the vision, being an organization which is accepted as a model in delivery of humanitarian aid relief both in Turkey and the world, and an organization which is the solidarity with people in their difficult times. You may know our common fundamental principles. This is must for all national societies accept all these principles: humanity, impartiality, neutrality, independence, voluntary services, unity, universality. So according to these fundamental principles, Turkish Red Crescent corporational structure is like an association. We are all honorable members, non-paid honorable persons, elected persons. Our General Assembly held every 3 years. Our delegation from the branches voting for the headquarters board, so fully independent and also compliance with all these seven principles. What are our activities? Main, you know, the disaster relief. We have 9 regional and 25 local disaster operation centers. We have huge warehouses. What we are providing there, emergency feeding, nutrition through our mobile bakeries, kitchens, and catering vehicles. You may see in the border of the Suriye, the Kilis, Hatay, Yayladağ, Öncüpınar, and other border, you can see our activities, current activities. Supporting the role of the government in provision emergency sheltering here. Turkish Red Crescent is the second tent manufacturing association in the movement. The one is Iranian Red Crescent, the second is Turkish Red Crescent. We have two factories, one in Ankara, another in Erzincan. So we have daily 600 tent manufacturing capacity in our factories. So we are investing this shelter in collaboration with European Shelter Research Institution. We are producing new generation shelter for the humanitarian stakeholders. We have 17 regional blood centers and 65 regional local blood donation centers. Distinguished guests, we are collecting annually 2.1 million unit blood and providing safe and high quality blood to the 1,250 hospitals in Turkey, all in our all regions. This is our biggest operation in Turkey. We have another responsibilities for the marrow transplantation and the stem cell therapy. So we are collecting the marrow samples from the donors, now reach over than 100,000 also donors in that Turkok project. We have social services, soap kitchens, elderly houses, dormitories. We have social markets. This is a little bit maybe strange for you. We are opening these markets in the universities, so we are providing for free clothes to the needy students, and they have cards and they have right to shopping in the social markets for free. So the first hand also clothes we are providing. We have one house for the homeless people. We have special education classes. We have Kurbani campaigns. We have some other donation program in our Islamic community. And food parcel program during the Ramadan period. We have 2 hospitals and 3 medical centers in Turkey. So we are providing high quality healthcare services to our community. And refugees and other migrants as well. We have 35 first aid training centers in our different provinces. So we are providing certification for the first aid and advanced life support and risk reduction training program to our society. As for our international program, So till now, Turkish Red Crescent has reached more than 130 countries since its establishment. You may know during the Second World War, the Greece siege from the German troops and the British army 1941. Because of that siege, roughly 100,000 people died because of famine in Greece. So Turkish Red Crescent sent five ships to the Atenpire harbor for the humanitarian aid. This is a symbolic because we fight before 20 years with Greece, but we provide the humanitarian assistance during their also suffering period. Nowadays, we have permanent delegations in five different countries: Somalia, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Palestine, both in West Bank and Gaza, Iraq, and Northern Cyprus of Turkish Republic. You know the Turkish migration services, and we have we recently set up this migration services department in Turkish Red Crescent. Now, under the management of the AFAD, roughly in 10 provinces, 17 tent cities. We are not calling these cities as camp. This is like a cities. And we have 7 container cities and roughly 250,000 people now living in these cities. And we are providing several services to the camp settlers. For the IDPs who are suffering inside Syria, you know, our main responsibility, zero-point delivery. And recently we started our cross-border operation in collaboration with the Syrian Arab Red Crescent. This is good news, actually. We were trying to make an agreement with the Syrian Arab Red Crescent last for 5 years. So by the support of the Mr. Peter Maurer and the president of the chairman of the ICRC and the president of the Syrian Arab Red Crescent, Dr. Attar, we signed several agreements with the Syrian Arab Red Crescent branches, so Idlib and Aleppo, I think, Aleppo, yes. So we are operating cross-border humanitarian relief in collaboration with Syrian partners. We are operating 12 border points, but now because of the political situation, mainly Kilis and the Reyhanlı and the Yayladağ points operating. What else? Maybe Atme camps, the Atme custom gates. We are operating. We are assisting all international humanitarian organizations for delivering their relief items to inside Syria. We have selected, nominated partners inside Syria, the associations, humanitarian organizations. We are delivering our goods to them and they are dispatching and they are reporting to us. Till now, roughly 2 billion Turkish lira worth of humanitarian reliefs we sent. Daily, we are sending 20 trucks inside Syria. You know, roughly 11 million people also fled their regions, homes, because of the armed conflict. And roughly 5 million fled the country. The rest of 7 million people became IDP inside Syria. So they are suffering and they are moving daily from center to rural, rural to center. So they are really suffering. If you compare with the refugees, IDPs is most vulnerable community. So we have to support this community inside Syria as the humanitarian actors. We have our, maybe you know, the famous program, the Kızılay Kart program. This is the e-voucher program we are providing, funded by European Commission, ECHO, and implemented partner, World Food Program. Now, we have a two-dimensional implementation system. You can see this Kızılay Kart here, like a credit card. So we are also giving monthly money, so loading money to this card. And now currently in 11 camps, roughly 30,000 cardholders and 150,000 beneficiaries also taking advantages from this e-voucher program. Till now we spent 350 million Turkish lira, roughly 100 million euros in income cardholders. And we have inside camps 24 contracted markets, so they can buy freely their needs. So another dimension of camp implementation. This is more important than the income implementation, I think. So now the number reached to 23,000 cardholders out of camps. And beneficiaries, more than 100,000, 115,000 beneficiaries. We have social survey workers, and they are assessing the situation of the people. They are living in the provinces, like our ordinary citizens. But we have the priority need assessment matrix. So we are selecting the handicaps, the widows, the elders, the first. So according to their rank, we are providing this card to that needy people. Now we are in 5 provinces, and we are expecting our valuable partners, European Commission, and the European ECHO for releasing this famous 3 billion euros for supporting this our program. The Commission also announced that last week, end of the June, they release 1 billion euros. So we are expecting this the donation grant from the our European valuable partners. We have child protection project in collaboration with the UNICEF. So this is like a psychosocial support and the compliance program for the kids. We started May 2013 in different camps, 22 camps, 4 community centers and 2 mobile child-friendly spaces. Yes. This program important. Why? Because we are empowering the Syrian youth. We are providing training for the leadership, and the Syrian youth leaders supporting their own colleagues in the camps. This is important So now reach 122,000 school age children and the adolescent also period kids. We have community centers. So currently Istanbul, Şanlıurfa, Konya ve and Ankara, upcoming Kilis. We signed an agreement, European Madat Fund, you know, the trust fund, and in collaboration with the Red Cross, Danish Red Cross. So it will be joint program, and these community centers will be reach 20 in Turkey, in different provinces. What we are doing inside these community centers? We have child psychosocial programs, and also adult programs. We have seminars, multidimensional also seminars. We have, this is important, case tracking and the referral services system. Our Syrian refugees submitting our communities by different problems. And if we are providing their needy requirements, so we are recording their names in our social service list. If that requirements out of our scope, we are refer to other public services. This is a tracing system for them. And other, and the most important is the harmonization and the cultural activities. We are providing Turkish language courses and occupational course for the women and other young generation as well. In our last General Assembly in beginning of April, our General Assembly delegation approved our 2020 vision strategic plans. As a summary, we have some programs and the areas we will focus on more. So I would like to share with you this, our vision projects. We are opening public health division. So we will produce mosquito nets, especially for the sub-Saharan LDC countries and the Asia-Pacific LDC countries for free. We will establish international Turkish Red Crescent International Nursing and Public Health Schools. This is School of Public Health. The first we will open in Mogadishu in June. We are waiting the approval from our president Erdogan. They will visit Mogadishu most probably in June for opening a Turkish embassy in Mogadishu. During that ceremony, we will open our first international nursing school. Then we will extend our schools sub-Saharan countries and Asia-Pacific countries which are in LDC countries. Blood service projects. The Turkish need of blood annually roughly 2.6 million. We are collecting 2.1 million. So we will meet all blood needs throughout Turkey. This is our strategic aim. And till 2017, we will establish plasma fractionation factory in Turkey, and we will produce our blood products in our own factory in collaboration with the private sector. We will open a hospice for the terminal patients for the palliative care. And so in Bakırköy, we started this geriatric hospital. This is the first geriatric hospital in Turkey. experienced hospital. We will open international nutrition centers in collaboration with the UNICEF, also affected countries because of the drought and famine crisis. We will have several development projects, capacity building programs for our own structure. We will set up Kızılay Academy and humanitarian aid training center, blood research institution, nutrition institution, R&D center, and we will empower our branches. So we will building up inshallah in Ankara new headquarter. It will be the biggest headquarter in the Red Crescent and the Red Cross movement. Roughly it will have 60,000 square meter closed area capacity, and we will provide the spaces to our partners, IFRC, ICRC and other international humanitarian agencies for free, these spaces. So it will be a center for the humanitarian action in Ankara. We will set up three museums, one in Istanbul, other in Ankara, the third one is in Gallipoli. We will set up advanced voluntary system, donation management system, campaign management system. So our IT tender awarded, and the famous ERP company SAP also took this award, and we will implement in collaboration with the SAP this ERP, advanced ERP system for our operations. Yes, as for the humanitarian summit, dear colleagues, the World Humanitarian Summit will be a milestone for updating and reshape humanitarian relief system and the development targets. In the summit, it is aimed to determine post-2015 agenda in the field of humanitarian relief, humanitarian intervention, and to shape reforms to leverage international law and the practice in this field. You know, our humanitarian system, relief system, and international common strategies for humanitarian crises were discussed approximately 25 years ago. The most extensive review and the reform in this field until today was made in 2005. This reform brought to humanitarian system trilateral approach, you know, the coordination, the UN OCHA have been set up in that reform. So partnership, cluster approach, and the sustainable financial approach also setting up in that reform. But we need new reform. Today all parties accept that the existing structure of a quarter century needs a radical reform. And this discussion will be shaped in flesh and bones in this year in Istanbul. The humanitarian crisis we have been facing cannot be overcome despite all efforts of the states, international system, civil societies, and individuals. And the gap has been widening with each passing days. Today, more than 60 million people have been forced to flee their homes due to conflict and violence. Roughly 220 million people were directly affected by disasters and became needy in the last 20 years. Also, in comparison with the last 20 years, the number of population living in need of humanitarian relief doubled and reached from 40 million to approximately 60 million currently. Operation costs of the humanitarian relief directed by the United Nations agencies or intergovernmental organizations increased from $3.4 billion in 2003 to $20 billion in 2015. But unfortunately, only 42% of the UN call for action is financed This is weaknesses of the international humanitarian financing system. We can understand the magnitude of the real requirement and the drama in the field better. For people forced to flee their homes due to the increase in the number and the frequency of the conflicts, extension of periods of conflict, the high number of affected population, and increase in climate disasters, this is most important point, the time spent away from their native country rose to 18 years on average. We are in the sixth year in the Syrian crisis. You can understand the drama of the people. Today, roughly 5,000 humanitarian relief organizations with 500,000 employees and a budget of $25 billion throughout the world work for responding to the disaster and the crisis, natural or man-made disaster. NGOs, international NGOs, are covering approximately 50% of the total burden. Red Cross and Red Crescent movement and the government agencies respond to natural and man-made disasters with their budget shares of 25% each. We must rise up this rate as Red Cross and Red Crescent movement. This is most important point. We will rise as Turkish Red Crescent in the World Humanitarian Summit. The movement, Red Cross and Red Crescent movement, must more active in the humanitarian crisis, especially in the armed conflict crisis. However, the weight of the world's political and the military agenda and the polarization of the countries and the regions are the greatest risk for this initiative that requires synergy. We will handle these risks as the movement. You know the World Humanitarian Summit agenda briefly, but the objective, the development of the proposals on possible solutions to the problems facing the global humanitarian system. We will discuss the structure as the stakeholders of the humanitarian system. The drawing of agenda for the future humanitarian aid reforms. Expecting outcomes, the chair's summary will reflect the main discussions and the commitments emerging from the summit and the way forward beyond Istanbul. The issuance of the report by UN Secretary General, the list of commitments by all concerned parties engaged. You know, five core responsibilities announced by the UN Secretary General's reports in leave no one behind. This is important for reduce and address the displacement. Address migrants' vulnerabilities and provide more regular and legal opportunities for migration and statelessness in the next decade. This is really shame for the international community. Empower and protect women and the girls. Eradicate gender-based violence and treat survivors with dignity. Eliminate gaps in education for children, adolescents and the youth. Enable adolescents and the youth to be agents of positive transformation. Prevent and end conflicts, political leadership, so we can say. Demonstrate timely, coherent and decisive leadership. Act early, stay engaged and invest in stability. Develop solutions with and for people. Respect rules of war, IHL. Respect and protect civilians and the civilian objects in the conduct of hostilities. And humanitarian relief workers as well, especially. We lost roughly 300 health workers in last years and more than 600 relief workers last year. This is unacceptable for our system. Ensure full access to and protection of the humanitarian and the relief and the medical mission. Invest in humanity, invest in local capacities, invest in risk, invest in stability, shift from funding to financing, diversity for resource base and increase cost efficiency. And innovation, working differently to end need, reinforce, do not replace national and local systems. This is new approach. Deliver collective outcomes, transcend humanitarian development divide. Summit from Turkey's standpoints, you know, the biggest refugee hosting donor nation in the world, the Turkish nation. Now we have roughly 3 million refugees we are hosting. One of the most generous donor nations in respect to its GDP. We are allocating 0.21% from our total GDP for the international humanitarian assistance. Because of this, the Turkey is the most generous country. Promoting the collective solution and the responsibility sharing with all stakeholders around the world. Seeking efficient solutions for obstacles faced by humanitarian systems. Restructure the global humanitarian system according to emerging needs, actively supporting the new agenda for future of humanitarian aid. We have several expectations, so I think our colleagues gave our presentation to you, so you can see the details. So. We will organize and we will participate some side events during this World Humanitarian Summits. Some important side events. Impact assessment study of child protection program as part of the Syria emergency response side events we will present. The Organization of Islamic Cooperation member countries. This will be a brainstorm roundtable. Side event. We will try to set up an alliance for the OIC member countries, Red Crescent and Red Cross Societies Alliance among OIC countries as Turkish Red Crescent. Everywhere for everyone, promoting the safety and the dignity of the people who migrate. This will be in Red Cross and Red Crescent Movement side event. We will join legal status of the Syrians in Turkey within the scope of provided services, emergency and humanitarian aid. Dear colleagues, roughly 125 different side events will be held in summit and some exhibitions as well. We are preparing Time Tunnel exhibition, fifth level, I think, in the convention center. You may know Istanbul Convention Center, Convention Valley in Harbiye. E-voucher, we will present our e-voucher Kızılay Kart program, community centers, disaster simulations game, international soup, lunch and dinner. You will join and this our multicultural cousin also soup and lunch and dinner.